love you, Father. We give you praise, glory. We celebrate your faithfulness. We honor you and we honor you. We bless you for who you are. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' precious name we worship. Our God, our Father, our King. What can we say than to say thank you?
Thank you, Father Lord.
For how you have loved us this much. Thank you for helping us this far. Thank you, because without you, we cannot go far.
Yes, Lord.
Where we are today is because of what you are doing in our lives.
Yes, Lord.
What we have today is because of what you have given to us.
Yes, Lord.
Because every good and perfect gift comes from above.
Yes.
And no man can receive anything except it has been given from heaven. We thank you for what we have.
Amen.
Thank you for life.
Thank you,
thank you for joy. Thank you for peace. Thank you for the things that are not enough.
Thank you
for the ones that are more than enough.
Thank you
for the ones that are not sufficient. Thank you for the ones we have that others don't have. Thank you for the ones that we don't have that others have. Maybe we don't need. Thank you for all we are and what we have at this time. Because we know that even if our beginning is small, our later end shall increase.
Amen.
We give you praise and glory. Please be glorified today. Accept our honor and praise. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you for January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October is when. Thank you for the remaining months in this year. Thank you for what we have promised that we have not yet gotten. Because we know we are getting there. Thank you because you will not fail us. Thank you because you will not turn your back against us. Please be glorified. In the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, today we pray thee that even as this day is the day that the Lord has made.
Amen.
As we round up our marital empowerment series, we pray the Almighty that by the reason of today's service, you will build up everybody.
Amen.
You will change everyone's story.
Amen.
You will change everyone's circumstances.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Whatever must not continue with anyone into the remaining months in this year, today will be a day of demarcation.
Amen.
Today will be a day of separation.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
For your son and your daughter that is saying amen loud and clear, close every chapter of sorrow.
Amen.
Open a new chapter of success.
Amen.
Open a new chapter of testimony.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Whatever has defeated them up to this point, that has refused to give them greetings, praises. Whatever has refused to allow them have peace. Whatever has refused to allow them have rest. Today, in the name of Jesus, deal with all of those things. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Today, because you always crown the year with your fatness.
Yes, Lord.
You crown it with your goodness. And the path is dropping fatness. Today, I pray thee that every good thing that your people need, for them to end this year better than they have started, let the heaven be open to them. Let the releases come down. In the name of Jesus Christ. Everyone here that has been having sorrow of mind, you have been having what the Lord is talking to me about. He said you are having weepings of the night. Weepings may endure in the night. The weepings of the night that you are the only one that knows what is causing you to cry. You have wet your pillow with your tears. You are the only one that knows what is causing you tears. But I have come as a messenger today that in the name that is above every other name, weep no more. Your night of weeping is over. Your morning of joy has come. In the name of Jesus Christ. Whatever God has promised you, that it looks as if there is no way this thing can still happen this year. I am sent to you today to declare
Amen.
That the same God that has promised is still well able to perform.
Amen.
As a matter of fact, he doesn't need all the days in this year to do it.
Amen.
By the word of the Lord, as you stand in the place of prayer today, every angry promise and prophecy of God that looks as if they have failed over your life this year, before your face they shall come to pass.
Amen.
In this season they will come to maturity.
Amen.
So shall it be for you.
Amen.
Father, we ask of you today that you anoint our tongues with authority.
Amen.
Every declaration today will become manifestation.
Amen.
So shall it be.
Amen.
Thank you, Holy Spirit. Blessed be your name. Jesus' mighty name we pray. And all the people of God say big amen. Please celebrate Jesus with your clap offering. Be seated for a minute. We have a couple of assignments to accomplish today by the Spirit of God. And I want to take them one after the other. We're going to conclude our prayer series that we started in the book of Psalm 66 as we still consider the series of prayer direction for the month, which is, it is your month to scale new heights.
Amen.
And we want to pray it to the full. We started looking at a scripture, Psalm 66, open up with me, verse 12. As part of every other thing to do today, we are going to be praying. Psalm 66 and verse 12. We looked at that scripture and we have prayed out some things by revelation. If you are there, say amen.
Amen.
If you are not there, you need the Bible, say I need the Bible. Alright. And if you are friendly and loving and love, you can share Bible with your neighbor. Psalm 66 verse 12. The Bible says, thou hast cursed men to ride over our heads. Talking about God. The psalmist there was narrating his experience. That God, you have permitted men to ride over our heads. And I did mention that what happened here was men were taking advantage of the silence of God over the children of God. And please understand that the silence of God does not connote the weakness of God. Thou hast allowed, permitted men to ride upon our heads. And now we have prayed out that part of the scripture that there are some areas of our life that the operations of men has made so many incapacitated. So many that should have moved ahead are not able to move ahead because of what man is doing or what the sons of men are doing. What is in the power of man. And many destinies are stranded because what men supposed to release to them, they are withholding. Thou hast caused men to ride over our heads. They cheated us. They took advantage of us. They messed us up. They blocked our way. They did as if they are our God. But that was not the end of the story. Men might have used you. Men might have offed you. Might not have offended you. Men or women in all category might have used their influence, position, and authority as well as connection to make something work adversely for you. But God is sending a word. Everything that man has done against you negatively, there is about to be a turnaround in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May I announce for somebody, I don't know who this is, but God is asking me to tell you that when men put Joseph, when they sold him, they thought it was the end, but they never knew they were giving him a fresh start. You might have looked at what men they are doing against you now to conclude that humanity, they are wicked. But I have a news for you. For some of you, if the wickedness of men is only opening door for a new season in your life.
Amen.
Come on now. Thank you, Jesus. The reproach of Benaiah concerning Hannah was what pushed and made able to come. If they had not sold Joseph into Egypt, how would he have taken his place that was available in Egypt? The word just came for someone that even that which men are doing against you, what they are doing tenaciously to make you look as if you are a loser, is only going to open a new chapter in your life in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
May I pray for you? Say in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You are not here. Say in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Oh God, my Father,
use everything
that the sons of men are doing against me to work for me. the sons of men are doing against me on the earth to change my story, to move me on, to advance me. Say a big amen if you believe. Joseph said, thou meant it for evil, but God turned it around for my good. Now, you cast men to ride upon our heads as if you are not our God. But the Bible says we went through fire and we went through water. Many times when the operations of the sons of men are involved, they make us pass through what we are not supposed to be passing through. And some of you are passing through tough times as if you don't pray. Passing through stumblings as if you are not working. But today there is a news for you in the scripture. He said, but thou broughtest us out by the power of God. Today you are coming out. Where you ought not to be, that you are still managing there, you are coming out. And what God wants me to pray and where we want to pray those two prayers from is the last section of that scripture. We have prayed the first section. We want to conclude with the last section. A chapter was opened in our life. It was not favorable. But thank God for God that can change any time and season. Someone is about to pray that God change the seasons of my life to the seasons that will be favorable.
Amen.
Are you with me?
Yes.
Because as the Lord lives before whom I stand and to whom I belong, whatever you have suffered this year as an attack, as a trouble, as a crisis, this remaining months in this year will pay back with goodness.
Yeah.
Because the Bible says so.
Yeah.
Thou crownest the year with your goodness. The Bible says so. That is the God we serve. Psalm 65 verse 11. Just look at, we are looking at 66. Just look backward and look at Psalm 65. Thou crownest the year with thy goodness. So whatever it is that we have suffered as not good, there is about to be a crown. And thy paths drop fatness. They don't drop failure, they drop fatness. They don't drop stagnation, they drop fatness. Thy paths, the paths that leads to the end of the year, they must drop something for you. Come on now. Whatever this year has eaten away from your life, this remaining months will vomit back to you. What are we praying? But thou broughtest us out into a wealthy place. Another version said a large place. Another version said a favorable place. We were in a place before, but where we were was not good. But because you are God that can change season and time, you brought us out into a better place. What are we praying for? Number one prayer is anywhere I am now. Every place I am now that is not favorable, everywhere the situation of this year has put me that is not testimony for, Lord, change my position.
Amen.
The people that came to church are not here. Because you saw us when we were passing through fire. You saw us when we were passing through water. But thank God that you can still do something.
Amen.
I have a news for you. What you are passing through is not the end of your journey.
Amen.
What you are passing through is only taking you to somewhere.
That's right. No.
The allegations might be tough, but you are coming out of it. Thank you, Jesus. I want that to sing so that when you pray, you know what you are praying for. Thou cast men to ride upon us, but thank God because you are God. Man is not God. Anyone bragging over your life, they will see your God in action. They will see your God in action. Those that saw, they said they have captured you. They thought they have seen your end. They will only see that you are rising up again. Somebody's business is rising up again. Your family is rising up again. Your marriage is rising up again. For there is hope for a tree, even though it is cut off, at the scent of water, in Satoria, in Ansekatar Sharia, it shall spring forth again. Someone is listening to me on the radio. What you thought is dead is coming back alive. The love in your marriage is coming back alive. Rise up on your feet with me. I want to pray. Say in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Oh, voice and begin to pray. God must turn around the negativity I have passed through. Whatever be your negative experiences this year, you have suffered losses, you have lost money, you have lost opportunities. Things have not just worked well from the beginning of the year till now. I close that chapter in your life. According to the word of God, every negative experiences must give way right now. Negativity must close off. In the name of Jesus, I decree and I declare, by the reason of tonight's encounter, every negative experiences and negativity in your journey, I declare a turnaround. In the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says we pass through fire. We pass through water. But you brought us out. You did not just bring us out into a place. You took us to a wealthy place. Whatever that place means for you, I don't know. But I can interpret. What it means, number one, is a place of recovery. Amen. When God takes somebody into a wealthy place, it means that whatever you need for life and sustenance is there.
Yes, yes. Thank you, Jesus.
Listen to me. There are houses and there are houses.
Yes.
There are houses you will see and you say, is this one house?
Yes.
There are places you will enter and you will be missing inside the building.
Yes, yes.
When we talk about wealthy place, God is talking about something. Can you imagine God building a place, call it wealthy place? Another one, call it a favorable place. Another person, call it a large place.
Yes.
Number two thing, when God takes you to a wealthy place, it's not just a place of recovery. It's also a place of advancement.
Yes.
Because in your wealthy place, you have everything to advance.
Yes.
When God takes you into your wealthy place, it's also a place of glorification.
Yes.
That the people that saw you passing through fire and water will now look at you and say, is this still you?
Yes.
Is this still you? Is this still you? Or somebody else we are saying, somebody's life is about to be decorated today.
Yes.
My God, my God. In the precious name of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Therefore, you are going to cry, say in the name of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Oh God of heaven, take me out today from the place of fire and the place of water. In the name of Jesus Christ, lift up your voice and begin to pray. There is a wealthy place for you in life. There is a better place for you in life. Take me out from passing through water. Take me out from passing through fire. Take me to my wealthy place. Take me to a better place. Take me to a place of honor. Even this year season, there is a better place for me. A wealthy place is a place of goodness. A wealthy place is a place of wealth. Neko se prato sila dayama shapa. There is a wealthy place for me. Laki pasuta rama shada. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. I pray for you as you say, amen. Whatever signifies a worthy place concerning your own situation, may God take you there.
Amen.
A worthy place is a better place.
Amen.
A worthy place is a place of relief.
Amen.
A worthy place is a place of recovery.
Amen.
I prophesy by the Spirit of the Lord for everyone under the sound of my voice that this year has been tough for you. It has been as if you are passing through fire. It has been as if you are passing through water. But the Bible says the fire and the water is not the end. There is still a place. And the place is called a worthy place. May God take you to your worthy place. Come out from the place of fire. Come out from the place of struggle. Come out from the place of failure. Get into your worthy place. Get into your place of honor. Get into your place of recovery. In the name of Jesus Christ. Somebody shout a big amen. Thank you, my Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
Oh, thank you, Ancient of Peace. Thank you, Ancient of Peace. Thank you, Ancient of Peace. Oh, Masuka Palado, Shadi, Endela Suka Parada Salusha, Manebre no Fakaposke Prayer. I saw a half open door. And the Lord said to me to announce to his children that what's supposed to be fully operational in your life is just springing little by little. The land actually is fruitful, but the opportunities are little for you. But he said the news is this: there is a large place for you. Whatever has made your door to be half open, rather than it to be fully open. For that will set the table before me, even in the presence of my enemy. And the enemies will not be able to do anything on the table. Neither will they be able to do anything against me that is sitting on the table. Everyone here under the sound of my voice, that certain things have been happening to you to shut the door that has been opened for you before. The door that you have been going through and coming out before, that there is no trouble. But now you are sensing some stress, some troubles, some difficulties, and it looks as if this is not the same place I've been going through before. I hear a voice from heaven saying to me to pronounce that whatever wants to hinder you from enjoying the good thing you have been enjoying before, today may God scatter out of it. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I declare your doors open. I declare your joy full. In the name of Jesus Christ, better opportunities for you. Better blessings for you. Thank you, Agent of this. Now, the Lord said to tell you that every tongue that has risen up against you in judgment shall be condemned.
Amen.
What you lost to opening of heart, whiteness of heart, lightness of heart, in order to cover the shame of others, God said to me, it will restore back to you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Your days of weeping is over.
Amen.
Say the Lord of hosts.
Amen.
I prophesy into your life. Can I pray for you? Elsa so glad for those. Electro in a shadaba. Pa! Palikata! And the Lucifer Cashet in Parono Sola Piki. Igalito Siperano Shataya. Yes, Holy Spirit, I release her. That you perfect that work in our life. Remove every hindrance. Everything causing inconveniences in your body. Your ears. Every moving object in your body, every imperfection, in the name of Jesus Christ, Holy Spirit, as I come through, I ask for the balm of Gilead, I ask for the power of heaven, I ask for the healing spirit, I ask for the power of recovery and restoration, that you eat and take out and fully restore right now. 1, 2, 3, power of the soul shall live for you. Everyone under the sound of my voice, thank you, my Father. I hear and I prophesy. Now, wherever what's supposed to be bringing gladness and joy to you now in this season has been taken away from you, there shall be total recovery.
Amen.
There shall be total restoration. In the name of Jesus Christ.